One of the things that we know about hypertension is first of all, it affects one out of every three adults. It's an epidemic in our country, and it's one of the major concerns of institutes like NIH and American Heart Association.
Primarily two disease models, hypertension, which is higher blood pressure, and lower blood pressure, which is orthostatic intolerance. So for someone who just have really low blood pressure, and they may have trouble to standing up like this.
So with the micronography technique, we're taking a tungsten microelectrode and we're inserting it into the peroneal nerve. And this right now is the gold standard for assessing sympathetic traffic. It's the only method out there where we can get direct signals of sympathetic traffic. When we're probing for a sympathetic nerve, we're listening for what we call an insertion burst. And that insertion burst will give us an indication that we're actually in the nerve. Now, we still have to make tiny micro adjustments sometimes in order to get there because we're actually recording from multiple fibers. And what we're interested in is individuals who are more prone to fainting have lower sympathetic tone, lower sympathetic traffic, and or they have a reduced ability to increase sympathetic traffic. So on one scale, on one side of the spectrum, we're looking at fainting and orthostatic intolerance. On the other side of the scale, someone who has a high sympathetic traffic outflow and tone often is associated with hypertension. And so we look at these patients and try to characterize their activity levels, and then we expose them to various types of interventions. So one intervention is getting more sleep, other interventions are physical activity. One that we just completed was looking at the effects of omega-3 fatty acids or fish oils on neurovascular control. So the long-term goal of this laboratory is to examine not only how the sympathetic nervous system responds in individuals, but how various types of interventions affect that responsiveness.